to take a rickety trolley alone to the seashore.
I wonder why Mother and Father didn't want to come with us.
Maybe they don't like this rickety trolley.
Rickety is a word here which means unsteady or likely to collapse at any moment.
Hey, kids, aren't you going to the Festive Fun Fair with all the jolly rides and games and snacks?
Festive means fun.
We know what festive means.
Thank you, but it's a perfect morning to go to the beach.
It's gray and cloudy.
That's what makes it perfect.
Suit yourself.
When Briny Beach was hot and sunny, the seashore was crowded with tourists, and it was impossible to find a good place to lay one's blanket. On gray and cloudy days, the Baudelaires had the beach more or less to themselves so they could work together on their projects and experiments.
Are you ready?
Let's get to work.
Do you think this will be as good as the mailbox?
I think this will be even better than the mailbox.
Violet Baudelaire was the eldest Baudelaire child. She was 14 years old, right-handed. Had a real knack for inventing and building unusual devices.
I'm having a problem with the grandfather clock.
Can you show me what the specific issues are?
See, it toasts the bread, but the minute hand falls behind 5 minutes.
It could be a problem with the gears.
That'd be disappointing. I made them myself.
When Violet Baudelaire tied her hair up like that, it was a sure sign that the pulleys, levers, and gears of her inventing mind were working at top speed.
Klaus, at what angle are the prevailing currents?
The angle of the prevailing currents are 0.5.
Klaus Baudelaire was the middle child and only boy. He was a little older than 12 and wore glasses, which made him look intelligent.
Of course, we still need the right projectile.
He was intelligent.
Violet, I'm not sure I understand this passage of Proust.
Could you read it to me?
Happiness is beneficial for the body, but it is grief that develops the powers of the mind.
It could be the translation.
Look away, look away. Look away, look away. This show will wreck your evening, your whole life and your day. Every single episode is nothing but dismay. So look away, look away, look away. Three children lose their home and go to live with someone awful. He tries to steal their fortune with a plot that's not quite lawful. It's hard to fathom how the orphans manage to live through it, or how a decent person like yourself would even want to view it. Just look away, look away. There's nothing but horror and inconvenience on the way. Ask any stable person, should I watch? And they will say, look away,